You know, every now and then over at the Hollywood headquarters, a group of directors, they get together, they say, hey, you know what'd be really cool? Like, you know what our audience would really like? If we made a kid show, right? But we paid a bunch of artists and writers to come up with the most terrifying shit imaginable. Hey, that's a great idea. In fact, I made exactly what you're talking about right now. I call it The Shapies. The Shapies was this 2002 kid show that I watched as a kid about these shapes. There was like a ball, a triangle, a rectangle, and many others, right? The whole show was centered around helping kids identify these objects by giving the shapes a personality and like a distinct solo, making them stand out even more. Now, look at these shapes for a second. I want you to take a good look at them while I say this show didn't even last a single year. Didn't even last for half a year. And I really wonder why, you know? Could it be that maybe the kids weren't learning as much from the show as intended? Maybe the voice actors, maybe they weren't getting paid enough and they quit? Or maybe it could be that having your main characters of a kid show look like creatures from the seventh stage of hell might not be the greatest idea. There's something about the show, the beady eyes, the clunky textures, everything in the universe being sentient, the jittery animation, it builds up this sense of unease, you know, of fear. I feel like at any point in the show, I might just get up for a glass of water and find one of my family members dead in the kitchen as one of these shapes dances around the body singing their fucking shape songs. Now the Shapies, while yes, it gave every kid night terrors, it didn't even come close to the darkness that Disney released upon the globe. It's a movie called Can of Worms. And the scariest part about the movie isn't really the movie itself. It's the fact that the person that created these monstrosities is still out there, freely roaming the streets. So the movie's about this kid, this absolute dork loser, and he just sucks at life. So he's like, the reason I suck so much is because I'm special. I'm probably an alien. I don't belong on this planet. He gets the sanity knocked out of him in a football game. He starts hallucinating.
No! Don't let them get me!
Now, instead of going to a doctor to check to see if he has a concussion, he's like, nah, I don't need to do that. I just need to open the damn Stargate. Take note, his whole reason for opening the Stargate was for some alien to take him off of planet Earth. And when an alien comes to do just that, he's like, what? Take me off this planet? Why would I want to do that? Now, this is where the actual horror begins, right? If this kid doesn't go through the Stargate with this alien dog now, a bunch of other aliens will start popping up and they'll try to persuade him to go to their planet. And at first, it doesn't sound too scary until you see what they look like. But you know what? I can understand this one. You know, I can understand this one. I can even understand this one, despite the fact that if I look at it for more than 4 seconds, it makes me want to gouge out my eye sockets. But what the fuck is this? What is this? This is a PG movie, right? And they allowed the directors to get away with putting green slime over an aborted fetus and calling it an alien? And that's not even the scariest part of the movie. Later on exists this creature that comes through the Stargate, right? But he's not as nice as other aliens. In fact, he enslaves other races and he keeps them locked up. And at first it's like, oh, well, he just looks like a regular human. But then, what the hell?
You can keep your references, hey. You can keep your benefits. Whoa, I don't think I recommend, hey, anything y'all niggas say. Oh, y'all bitches think it's a game. Oh, y'all backbone soft like some play.